The Local Road Research Board has a history of capturing best practices of Minnesota's city and county engineers. Today, on the technological forefront is the use of Automatic Vehicle Location Systems, or AVL. AVL uses global positioning systems, GPS, to geographically locate and track vehicles. Data from AVL systems, or telematics, is a method of monitoring trucks, equipment, and other assets by using GPS technology and onboard diagnostics to plot the asset's movements on a computerized map. Data collection could include winter maintenance material usage, vehicle condition, and route progress tracking. While some city and county engineers have expanded the use of AVL by instrumenting various vehicles within the public works fleet, other agencies are just now considering implementation. Agencies want to assess if and how they should implement AVL. What is the return on investment? What are the advantages? And how this will help meet the needs of residents and operators. In the study, Using AVL GPS Telematics to Optimize Snow Plowing, 31 out of 58 participants responded that they actively use AVL on their maintenance equipment. To gain further insight into how AVL systems have helped local governments in Minnesota, users from Crow Wing County, the City of Crystal, and St. Louis County shared their experience with telematics.
Our biggest challenge with managing our operations are having enough resources to meet the customer's expectations. Even this last year, we've had a lot of storm events and trying to be everywhere at once with our crew, who does a phenomenal job, but it is difficult to meet every customer's expectations throughout the county.
For St. Louis County, the biggest challenges we have are our size. We have 3,000 centerline miles of roadway. We're 6,800 miles, square miles, and that makes it a challenge to have everybody on the same page and implementing things at the same time.
So for those that are just starting to wander into the GPS AVL system, what you really need to do is think about your application, right? It's not just during snow removal operations. It could be a storm response as well, and while you're trying to figure out where your people are and just to kind of have that personnel accountability. As you think through all the different applications, it'll help become apparent then how often you need the data uploaded to you.
When implementing an AVL system, there may be challenges to consider involving equipment purchases, employee buy-in, Wi-Fi or cellular access, and system utilization. Each agency will need to consider the practical integration of their system and how it'll be used during and outside of active events such as a snowstorm. Trust between supervisors and operators, transparency about data usage, and cooperation are the keys for a smooth transition to using telematics effectively.
Key for the buy-in of the group was being able to be part of the process. Being able to say, this is what we think would work, this should work, not us, your management saying, here's what you're going to do, do it. It just doesn't work in today's culture. People have to understand what we're asking of them and have to have buy-in for a product and believe in that product. And we had that from our initial sessions, that everybody was actually excited. When we first started to send out our reports or populate and publish our reports, there was a lot of apprehension, even by myself, that we were going to get nitpicked, we're going to have everything analyzed. And not that we shouldn't be transparent with the public, but sometimes they might not understand all the details. I was completely wrong. That hasn't happened. And the best benefit of reporting out what we're doing, the public can see we're trying. They know we're working in their best interest, and it's really changed the paradigm that our phone rings very seldom now during a snowplow event.
When selecting an AVL system, it's important to understand what needs, current and future, you're trying to fulfill. The clarification of these needs will help you to determine what AVL system would grant the best return on investment.
One of the biggest things when you're rolling out a GPS and AVL system is, quite frankly, the benefit to the operators. And so for us, it's not strictly are we using less salt kind of question, are we saving money there, but it's how are we being more efficient in our service delivery. And so we will show our staff video from previous plow events and say, hey, how can we improve on this? We've also used GPS where we had a storm response to go back and track who was where as we try to do some FEMA paperwork. So for us, the conversation about return on investment isn't so much strictly dollars saved on, let's say, salt, but it's improved efficiency either in the way things are done or, quite frankly, in processing some of the paperwork to remember how things played out, especially in a storm response.
Telematics equips maintenance managers with key performance indicators such as route and system completion time, route equity balance across the system, deadheading, and duplication of miles. Local governments also reported that material management, which included tracking salt usage, granular and liquid, spinner rates, and blast button usage, as another performance indicator used when evaluating winter operations.
The best return on investment has actually been materials management. We are currently down about 30% on our salt and sand use for the year. Even this year, where we've had 50 events and record snowfalls in the Duluth area, we are still at about our 100% quantity in the state contract. And in past years, we would have blown through our 120 pretty easy. The other part to it is the return on investment has paid off in us evaluating and assessing plow routes and being able to redirect staff and plows to help others that either got bogged down or breakdowns or whatever the reason would be.
That's the number one reason with the AVL that we got the system and are using it. And that helps me create reports that we do for each snowplow event. And we track the personnel time, the equipment time, the material costs, what material we used, if we had to switch materials. In some events, we use a combination that we'll use straight salt or treated salt, and then we might have to switch and go to a sand-salt mixture. Or straight sand, and just depending on what the roads are doing and what the event is giving us. But having all that data helps the drivers know how much they're putting down, and they're putting down the correct rate.
The benefits of telematics are transparency, efficiency, risk management, and safety. Better data collection improves transparency between operators and managers and between the public and local government.
We have 16 different routes, and we're looking to try to have all of our plows back to their shops within 15 minutes of each other. So we've taken the precise data and looked if someone's taking a little bit longer, can we shift somebody over? Can we change something up on those routes, looking at the AVL, to make it more equitable amongst all the drivers? And then also that in turn gives the customer a better product, that all the roads are getting done instead of one route before the other. And we've also partnered with our Soil and Water Conservation District to know that we're not overloading our lakes with chloride. The Crow Wing County has a very unique set of resources in our lakes, and it drives tourism in our communities and is really a big economic factor for us. So by putting down just enough salt to effectively do the job is also us being good stewards of the environment.
Efficiency can be increased using telematics. Places where roads were not plowed, where routes overlapped, or where plow time is imbalanced become more apparent with AVL.
One of the biggest things with the GPS and being able to collect the data and go back and view it later is you can get a total picture of how all the pieces of equipment are moving simultaneously. And so from time to time, we've actually brought all the staff together to watch that video and say, hey, here's how we did this. What ideas do you have? And so sometimes we'll tweak some routes with, you know, we have another plow operator who's very close to this other border area that somebody else used to do. Maybe we'll move that to their area. And so just little tweaks and adjustments because you can see the total picture at one time.
Risk management has been improved using recorded data to handle conflicts with the public. Such data gave clarity to local governments about reported situations with machinery location, speed, and direction. In our study, 21 out of 28 participants had used AVL data for risk management while defending a claim.
Yeah, so having the AVL systems on all of our trucks, we even have it on our mowing tractors, our motor grader, and some of our smaller pickup has kept us from entering into windshield claims has been one of the biggest. That we've had a number of people saying, your truck drove by and chipped my windshield, or I kicked up a rock and now my windshield's broken. Another big one for us is in the wintertime that we get the call that the snowplow came by my house at 50 miles an hour, blew my mail all over, knocked my garbage can over. When I can pull that data while I'm still on the phone with that customer and say, I'm looking and at your address, the driver was going 18 miles an hour, 16 miles an hour, 20 miles an hour. They're within our guidelines that we've got set for safe practices. We've had call from insurance companies saying the same thing that, you know, we caused damage to something and we go back in the AVL and look and see that we weren't even on the road that day. It wasn't us, it was somebody else. So a lot of those tort claims go away really quickly with having that data.
Using AVL also has safety benefits. GPS and vehicle condition notifications allow for a quick response to the location of operators when an issue occurs.
Other benefits to telematics are assisting EMS. As a call from emergency services comes in, you can look at the screen and route completion and know where's the closest truck. In a similar manner, trucks often slide off the road, get stuck, and you can, at a moment's notice, decide that, you know, Bob is over here and Jerry's there, Jerry's closest, and you can respond more timely in that regard as well.
There are several vendors to select from when determining the right AVL system for a city or county. Minnesota agencies have used Motorola, Precise Force America, Samsara, JD Link, Verizon Connect, Utilimark, and Razor. Each AVL vendor has advantages and disadvantages that each team will have to weigh when making their decision.
So for our GPS and AVL systems, Crow Wing County is using a Precise and Force America systems in all of our tandem trucks, in our motor graders, in our mower tractors, and we also have them in our smaller 1.5 ton trucks that are in our fleet and out patrolling on the roads also. We went through a pretty extensive process to determine what system would best meet our needs. And when we looked at Precise, it seemed to check all the boxes as far as the AVL for tracking our trucks and where they were at and where we wanted to go. Where we wanted to go on the AVL side was to get the public viewership, or so the public could know where our trucks were during a snow event. So we were able to incorporate Precise's technology with some in-house technology to come up with our Where's My Snowplow app. That Crow Wing County hosts and uses, that anybody can pull this app up at any time and see where our trucks are going and where they've been. We also, the biggest thing for us was tracking our material and knowing how much is being put down and where throughout our system.
Out of those who participated in the LRRB study, the most common vendor was Precise Force America, which numbered 22 out of 34 responses, followed by JD Link and Verizon, which had active use from three agencies each. AVL vendors have varying prices, pay frequencies, unit costs, and contract lengths.
Being customer focused is what our mission is centered around. Our mission is serve well, deliver value, and drive results. Those six simple words make it really easy for us to keep the customer in mind. Using Precise is just one little cog in that wheel of providing good service for our customers, making sure we're being good stewards of the resources and of the environment.
The biggest thing I would leave anybody with as they're looking to jump into AVL and telematics is it's not just about snow removal. There are a lot of benefits that we've talked about today that can play into public works operations. And so really go into that with that holistic view of where can having additional information or additional alerting be of help. You know, what is the data you need? What is the frequency of data you need? And what are some other benefits? Let that guide the process, not we just want to track our snow removal, because you're limiting yourself when you just take that approach.
For a quick resource guide on AVL systems, please go to LRRB.org and search telematics.